About 3 years ago, I decided to set up Myeloma New Zealand. I felt that myeloma patients did deserve an organisation that was specially catered to their particular needs in terms of better education, and also to try and make the patients, for want of a better word, feel more empowered about their condition. So we really just set it up from scratch. And it's been, in my humble opinion, quite successful. We've set up a Facebook page, and we've got 300 people on the Facebook page. We've actually got a very interactive website where we're continually trying to refresh and put new information on it. The other thing that we've done this year, which we think was very exciting, is that we commissioned a burden of disease report. And this is quite unique, actually. And it's very comprehensive. It took a chap called Richard Milne about a year to complete it, and he used data obtained from the cancer registry and also from other sources. And it's over 100 pages long, and there's really nothing like it that had ever been done in New Zealand before on a particular cancer. So it really gives us a very good handle of the extent and the prevalence. And we've now worked out that there are, in fact, 2,500 people living with myeloma in New Zealand. And people often, sometimes even people at Pharmac, the drug agency, make comments that myeloma is a rare disease. But I think you'd agree, if you've got 2,500 people living with myeloma, it's not rare. So, so another thing that we've done, we wanted to complement what's been done by Leukemia and Blood Cancer, who are more involved in support of patients. So we've been involved in patient education, and we've gone out and run seminars in various places. In fact, I did one about 3 weeks ago down in Dunedin in the far south, and we did it in conjunction with the LBC, and it worked really well. We did an afternoon seminar down there. So, and another thing that we're very involved with is advocacy, because we're not in the fortunate position that Australia has, which has funded a number of drugs recently. We haven't had any new drugs funded since 2014, and there are several important drugs that we would like Pharmac to fund. So we've had to, what we did, we wrote a petition, and we presented that to the Health Select Committee, which is a group of Labor and National and New Zealand First people. In fact, tomorrow, and I'm not going to be there, Pharmac are going to comment on the petition, and it'll be interesting just to know what they say.